Toymakers, today we are making hardware jewelry. So we're going to use what are called hex nuts. And it's called a hex nut because the shape is a hexagon, which means that it has 6 different sides. But you can use any kind of hardware for this. It comes in different sizes. There are plastic ones, there are square ones, big ones. You could even try using something like a washer, which is round, or some other kind of bead. But we're going to use metal today. So the materials that we need are our hex nuts. And we're going to need some sort of string or yarn or twine, something to hold them together. We're going to use the yarn to braid the hardware into the jewelry. And this is an example that I made. You can see it kind of goes either direction, and it looks kind of like a spine of a snake, maybe, or this pattern is kind of what we call herringbone. Get a piece of string or yarn that's 2 times longer than the final one. So if I want to make a bracelet, I'm going to wrap it loose around my wrist 1-2 times, and maybe just make sure there's a little extra. When you're done, it's easy to cut off the extra part, but it's a little bit harder to tie more string on if you want it to be longer. I'm going to cut 3 pieces that are the same length. I cut 1 piece, and so I can line it up with the string and cut a second piece that's exactly the same size. That's an easy way to measure and make sure that they're all the same and one of them doesn't end up too short. So now that I have my 3 pieces, I'm going to tie a knot at the top. So I'm just going to loop it around and put it through the hole and kind of push it to the top. When I'm wearing this as a bracelet, I'm going to want a little loop so that when it's done, I can tie it on my wrist. So I'm going to tie another knot, but I'm going to leave a little bit of space. And you can even get somebody to help you hold it while you do this if it's moving too much. There we go. So now I have a nice little loop at the top, and I'm ready to start braiding. I find it's helpful to tape this down to the table so that it doesn't move when I'm working. So I taped my yarn to the table, and I'm going to separate the 3 strings. So there's going to be 1 on the right side, 1 on the left side, and 1 in the middle. Now, if you've never braided before, it's pretty easy, but it takes some practice. You might want to try it a couple of times doing other projects maybe before you try to braid on the hardware, because that part gets a little bit tricky. But the way that you braid is you take the outside and you move it to the middle. You take the other side and move it to the middle. So you take the right side to the middle, the left side to the middle, and you keep doing that. And you want to do a couple of inches before we start putting on the hardware. So everything is switching position all the time. They're changing where they are. But it's always going to go right to the middle, left to the middle, right to the middle, left to the middle. And I'm going to get a couple inches braided here, maybe about as big as my hand. And you can do more, you can do less, depending on what kind of jewelry you're making and what you want it to look like. Now that I have a couple inches braided at the top, I'm going to take another piece of tape, and I'm just going to tape that down to the table because I don't want it to move around. Now I need to decide how many of the hex nuts I want to put on my bracelet. I think that about 10 or 12 is good for a bracelet, but it depends on how big your wrist is or how much you want to show. So I think this is about 12 right here. So I'm going to count out my pieces. You could try using different sizes or different kinds of hardware, or you can do them all the same. If they're very different sizes, though, it might be hard to get them to line up correctly. So I would say for your first project, you probably want to try using all the same kind until you get good at braiding them in. So I have 12 hex nuts here, and I've got my 3 strings. I'm going to start with the left string. I take the left string, and I'm just going to put it through the hole in the hex nut. So it's going to fall right onto my bracelet here. And as soon as I put the hex nut on, I'm going to put that string in the middle. And now I'm going to do the same thing on the right side. I'm going to take the right string, put a hex nut on it, push the hex nut to the top, and then put the string in the middle. If your hex nuts aren't tight in the braid, they're gonna fall off when you finish. So you wanna try and push them all the way to the top and braid as tight as you can. And if your string comes apart at the end, you can put a little bit of tape on it to make it stay pointy. So the string on the right now goes to the middle, but you want that hex nut to stay on the right side. And you're gonna keep going. You're gonna do left, right, left, right. So the string's gonna go, or the hex nut is gonna go on the string on the left, and then that string becomes the string in the middle. If things start to move around, just stop and try and fix them, or you can take it apart and start again. But it should go in order. It should start to look kind of like a ladder or stair steps, where there's one on each side, and they go kind of in a zigzag. I'm doing my last hex nut here. I'm gonna slip it on the yarn and pull it to the rest of them. And I'm going to just hold this with one hand and kind of try and push everything up one by one. Just one at a time, move it a little bit closer and try to get everything nice and tight. The tighter it is, the better it'll hold together when you're wearing it and it's moving around. So you want to try to make it as tight as you can. Now that those are all done, I'm going to keep braiding just like I did at the top here. Just going to do a regular braid without adding any hardware to it. So from the side to the middle, and then the other side to the middle, back and forth. And I'm going to go slow at first to make it tight. And then once I make sure that it's good, I'll just finish up. Now I can check to make sure it fits right. That's good. That little loop that I tied at the beginning, or did the knot and the space in the knot, I can separate that. And I can use the tail to go through that. And that's going to help hold that on my wrist when I'm wearing it. Just like that. And I can slide it so it's tight, or I can let it be a little bit loose. And I can get somebody to help me maybe tie it a little bit tighter so it stays. If you have what are called clasps, a little piece of metal that hook together like on necklaces or on bracelets that you buy in stores, you can also try tying those on. You can find those at stores that sell things to make jewelry. So I like mine to be kind of loose. So there we go, I have my hex nut bracelet. So you can also make something like a keychain this way. This one, I made it and then tied the keys on at the end. But when you do the loop at the top, you could tie the keys on then if you wanted to, if you knew that that's what you were going to use it for. You could also make a longer one and you could use it as a necklace. This one has plastic and metal in it. You could mix them up. This one also is braided with three different colors, which might be good if you're just learning how to braid, because then you can keep track of which color is which. If you don't braid tight enough, the hex nuts might fall and come loose, and you end up with a braid and then a big clump of metal. And it's kind of cool, but it definitely doesn't look like a fancy bracelet that you just made. It looks like you just strung them on. So you want to make sure that you braid nice and tight, or they end up falling apart and moving around a lot. Thanks for watching. If you make a cool braided piece of jewelry, or if you find a new way to use it, send us a picture. We'd love to see what you make. So remember, keep calm and make on.